My name is Mark Ricciardi. I'm one of the interventional cardiologists, and I oversee the section of interventional cardiology here at Northwestern. I've been in practice for about 15 years. I typically do the following procedures. They're procedures that are minimally invasive and what we call transcatheter procedures. That means that I can apply therapies to the heart through catheters, which are small tubes put in various arteries. And I typically work on the supply of the heart as well as the valves in the heart.
My name is Chris Malasery. I'm a cardiac surgeon at the Bloom Cardiovascular Institute of Northwestern Memorial Hospital in Chicago. I've been a cardiac surgeon at Northwestern for 7 years. My focus of cardiac surgery is in valvular heart disease as well as aortic disease. What attracted me to cardiac surgery is the opportunity to help patients in an immediate and quick fashion. It's always amazing to me how small a operation such as a valve replacement or a valve repair can lead to such a great improvement in patient symptoms.
Interventional cardiology also allows for a lot of innovation. Whenever you try to treat diseases and ailments, there's always this drive for innovation to do things more efficiently with smaller devices and ones that are much better tolerated. TAVR embodies a lot of what we think about in interventional cardiology, minimizing risk with the maximum outcome. It's the perfect minimally invasive interventional cardiology treatment.
TAVR is an acronym for transcatheter aortic valve replacement. It's a treatment for patients who are at high risk or inoperable with aortic stenosis.
My name is Stella McClellan. I'm 70 years old and I live in Tampa, Florida. Everybody told me I was going to die. They didn't beat around the bush. They told me I was going to die. This Dr. Morse, he'd went to school with the doctor at Northwestern, and they had come up with a new way to do things that didn't entail open heart surgery, but he didn't know I'd be a candidate for it or not.
Because every doctor she went to told her that she couldn't make it, you know, with an open heart surgery, and she has to get stronger and stronger, but she wouldn't get no stronger, she was getting weaker.
So Ms. McClellan was a very good candidate for the TAVR procedure because she was one of those patients who we were very concerned may not tolerate a conventional surgical approach.
And so he went and wrote to Dr. Russell. They interviewed me and had me come in, and within a week or so I was having my surgery.
She had a disease process that, left untreated, would likely cause her demise.
Aortic stenosis is a disease of the aortic valve where the valve becomes too tight and restricts blood flowing from the heart to the rest of the body. Aortic stenosis causes severe symptoms of shortness of breath, chest pain, and sometimes passing out. If left untreated, it can lead to heart failure.
I'm just very happy. I would recommend Northwestern and the surgery I've done to anybody.
Ms. McClellan did very well with her procedure. She recovered quickly, she was home quickly, but she did what we expect of our patients to do who went through her type of procedure, which is to recover rapidly and see almost an immediate improvement in symptoms.
My advice for patients who have aortic stenosis and are looking at TAVR as an option for treatment is to seek a team that is a multidisciplinary team, otherwise known as a heart valve team. These patients can be seen by both cardiac surgery and interventional cardiologist.
Northwestern is the best. They really treated my sister very, very good.
They waited on me hand and foot. Maybe I played them up a little.